convict.
Okay. I'm gonna buy one.
I get that?
I'm gonna buy one.
Look at that. Man said he was never coming to the dark side. Dude, I'm just a messenger. I'm just a vessel. I'm just trying to put good info out to the people and good content. Let them know what's on the market. The end of the day is preference, is choice. But pound for pound, I really don't think that Glock is shooting with that Canik. Oh, man.
I'm about to get one.
Until next time.
Woke up this morning. Yeah. You got yourself a gun.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Got yourself a
Yo,
gun.
Yo, I'm living in this time behind enemy lines, so I got mine, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
You from the hood, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
What's going on, shooters?
Hey, kind of young
Happy Sunday, boys and girls. Today is Gunday, it's your boy, man, and I thought I was going to have some good news for you. Took a road trip out to Florence, Texas, hoping to get my license to carry instructor certification. The more knowledge I get, the more I can share with my clients and my students. Mother Nature wasn't having it. Temperatures below 30 degrees, freezing ice, roads covered, crazy Texas drivers sliding all over the place, crashing. We was only able to get through one day of training. 14 hours in the classroom. While I'm thinking about it, shout out to Lattimore defense. Boy, I see you in there, adding another notch to your belt. You were just like me, fighting Sandman. 14 hour class, sitting up in there, almost losing to Sandman. I seen your head almost hit that desk a few times. Needless to say, these people had to cancel the class, reschedule us for Wednesday. The way I look at things is I take a negative and turn it into a positive. Your boy was not looking forward to shooting in 10 degree weather on Friday, worrying about my firearms malfunctioning. So we take it and turn it into a blessing. Maybe on Wednesday the weather will be a lot better. Hopefully above 40 to 50 degrees, your boy could go out there and put that work in. But today, I'm calling it Canik Mania. A big endorser of the brand. Why I like Canik so much? Why you see me out there with the Canik, putting that work in, getting in that training? Y'all boys know I'm a big time Canik man. I've been saying it since day one. The best bang for your buck out the box. Hands down. For the money, can't go wrong with the Canik. They come well equipped. You ain't got to do any customizing. You ain't got to take the sights off. You ain't got to swap out the trigger. Canik is ready to go. From the left to the right, you see the acquisition. Picked up the two SFXs first. Got the Combat Elite. And then lastly, picked up that TP9 SC, the subcompact. So right there, you're getting a good look at the Canik collection. So the Canik meat came out, or Mate, however they pronouncing it, pretty much the same firearm as the TP9 SFX. But what they did, they extended the release on the slide. They put a micro compact optic on it for the red dot. And that way you're able to keep that rear sight in the back. Because prior to that, the regular SFX, when you took the optic off, plate off, the rear sight went with it. And the Canik rival, supposed to be competition. It's got that flat trigger, the same one that's on the TP9 Combat Elite. Blacked out, looks real menacing. So just to get an idea, when you go to buy a Canik and you open up the box, like I say, they come well equipped. Obviously cleaning tools, same thing as most firearms. But what I really like is they come with a holster. Usually two or three magazines. Most of the time they give you at least two. to give you a lock. They're gonna give you some tools to get you started, taking off the optic plate and installing red dots on the Canik. Base plate, you're gonna get a back strap, and then right here you see the plate that comes already installed. And this is obviously before I put the Romeo on there. But yeah, the TP9 SC Elite, good bang for the buck. Subcompact, similar to the sizing of the Glock 19X. So right there, the Canik TP9 SFX, my go-to firearm, my first Canik. You checking it out. It's got that chamber indicator in the back. Slide release. Very easy to disassemble this firearm. Got the slide release levers on the side. Really easy to catch with your fingers. When you're looking at the slide, you see that it's got that ported slide. You got the fiber optics. Got the removable plate. The Dawson Precision sights on this Canik TP9. And then pretty much, I went out and got another one. Set it up for competitions. Put the Vortex Venom on it. Same gun, just added a red dot optic to it. There's no difference. This is just a blacked out version of the TP9 SFX. So the Canik TP9 Elite Combat. For a long time, I was trying to get my hands on this firearm. It's got the extended slide release, which is really cool, really easy. And it's ambidextrous, actually. It's on both sides. This one comes suppressor ready if you're into that, if you're looking to add a suppressor. Got the Picatinny rail on the bottom. Not much difference than the Big Brother SFX, only this one is suppressor ready. And the trigger is a big difference on these two firearms when you look at them. That's one of the first things that stands. So that trigger is really wide and it's flat on the front. Very, very, very nice trigger. It feels really good. It's got a really good release, a good reset. So I like to take it apart so you can take a look at how that trigger looks from the inside there. It's actually very different than the SFX. And again, like I said, this is the same trigger that they put in that Canik Rival. And I'm gonna just give you a quick comparison so you can see side by side and compare the two triggers. Obviously, this one has that trigger safety. And again, the trigger out the box is unbelievable. Anybody who shot a Canik will tell you that. But these triggers are very, very, very different. Both awesome triggers. Have to be honest, I love that Combat Elite flat face trigger. It's very cool. One of the best triggers that they put in one of their firearms. So, last but not least, the Canik TP9 Elite SC, standing for Subcompact. And this is the baby brother of the Canik series. A little bit smaller in size than the Combat Elite. It does have that extended slide release, which I thought is really cool. Although the trigger is not a flat face, it's much like the SFX trigger. Only they just added that red color to it, but it's pretty much the same trigger as the SFX. Not much difference. Just a smaller slide. Shorter slide. Kind of heavy, to be honest with you. in comparison to a lot of the other subcompacts. As you can see here, I got the Romeo Zero on there. And it's set up pretty nice where even with the sights, the factory sights, you're almost able to co-witness. And I didn't have to even upgrade to suppressor height sights. And this right here is what I consider an everyday carry weapon. But again, it does have some weight and size to it. So that's it. That's my lineup. Got the SFX, Combat Elite, and the Subcompact SC. Y'all need to stop playing, wasting your money on these inferior firearms. You need to start winning. Go out and cop you a Canik.